listing in San Diego, California. This is the 1991 Beneteau 32S5. So let me show you some features and benefits about this.
Here we are looking at the Beneteau 32S5. And as you can see, for its age, it is kept in pristine condition. The vessel was just hauled out and had bottom paint done, and it is absolutely turnkey in my opinion. The boat is shiny, it's waxed, it's very well taken care of, and there are so many things about this vessel that'll make it the perfect cruiser for the San Diego Bay, Mission Bay, and just getting you and your family out on the water. First thing I want to start about is looking at the foredeck. You can see there is a below deck furler there, and again, there's a nice suit of sails on it. This is a double spreader mast with rod rigging. At the very top, we have wind point wind speed. We also have wind direction. Then a nice mainsail cover as well too. Stainless steel lifelines with opening gates here on the side. And again, what this possesses is that traditional like Beneteau look with really stylish lines. You have a small hull port there. Opening ports, this really beautiful, you know, cabin top design where they've taken the windows around and molded them around the stainless steel grab handles. As we move up forward, you're gonna see this large Genoa track on the side of the boat. There's also aluminum tow rails that really allow a lot of nice form function to be able to attach things to and just really blow the minimum maintenance down. Double bow roller up front. Underneath here into the anchor locker, you can see there is a Horizon electric 500 12 volt windlass. There's our anchor there. And again, just a really nice design, very sleek. And one thing again, just the attention to detail with these cleats here, you can see the Beneteau logo, you know, molded into them. It's just all of these little things that really make this particular vessel stand out. As we move our way back aft, we can see all of the sheets and halyards leading into the cockpit. Again, this was a very ahead of its time boat, really, really well engineered. Look at the angle with the non-skid on this. It's just, again, well thought out. Plus, this is a large cockpit. So we have two cabin top winches, two general winches here, large traveler right here in the cockpit, but it doesn't, you know, get in the way. You notice that they have actually recessed it in here. The owner's also done a phenomenal job of taking care of all of the teak here, and again, very well thought out. Off to the starboard side in the cockpit, this is an opening lazarette locker. Again, you can just see how detail-oriented this particular owner is. There's your heart interface inverter charger. We also have our throttle system located here. Our shore power inlet, a really nice transom. The lifelines remove and it allows us to have access to this swim platform here. Underneath this little door is the swim ladder that drops out. We do have a shower as well and an adjustable backstay. Looking at the helm, we have a large leather-wrapped wheel on the wheel itself. This is our Raymarine, our auto helm autopilot. This is a nice function because all you do is pull down this little rocker switch, engages the autopilot, and then just above that, we have our auto helm depth, wind, and speed. Off to the starboard side is the Raymarine autopilot controller. Yeah, everywhere you look, it's just very well taken care of. We have a VHF RAM mic that's mounted here. And then again, we have our display for our Volvo Penta. This is our RPM. This is our fuel, and this is the engine hours, which show 1885. All right, so as we move up forward, we're gonna notice again just how large this cockpit is for the size of the boat it is. And we're gonna come down below and just see how beautiful the woodwork is. There are three steps coming down. We have the galley off to the port side. The galley itself has a three burner stove and oven, double stainless steel sinks, this really kind of clever, you know, tray that slides back. This opens up and you have a 12 volt refrigerator. So large capacity 12 volt refrigerator. Again, this will slide back, allowing you access here to the double sinks. Down below, we have a foot pump for this, and then we have the pressurized 12-volt pump for the fresh water. Underneath all of these areas, these are all sliding storage racks. Again, they've just utilized all the space, keeping this on a continuous little rail system here. As we look up above, here we have an opening shade, and then look at this opening port right above the stove. These are really just beautiful windows here. We have LED interior lighting. Directly across from this is our nav station. The nav station, again, kind of continues with this curved lines. We have a nice little bench seat here. This is our standard Horizon VHF with AIS. The standard Beneteau, breaker switches. We also have a Garmin GPS, Panasonic CD player, bilge pump switch, anchor windlass breaker, and then our heart interface. This is our controller for the charger. All right, forward of this beautiful, billet, base to the table here with a Beneteau, inlaid in that as well too. The salon table has leaves on both sides that open up. Just beautiful, design, even like in their cushions, just the curvature that they have here with the backrest, making it very, very comfortable. Inside of the salon table is a rack here that houses wine. So you can have five bottles of wine right there. And then obviously there's tons of storage, everywhere you go. Little utensil cabinet drawer there. Great use of space with all of this storage around. And again, they've just done a phenomenal job. You can even look in to the inner shroud chain plates, how those tie into the whole grid section of the vessel. It's just very well built. Compression post here in the salon forward, and then we go up to our V-berth. So the V-berth itself can have two doors here. That's what these hinges are for. This little section can remove so you can kind of step into the V-berth, but it's just a great use of space. Overhead opening hatch, again, with that same sliding cabinetry system. It really just stands out. Here is a little hanging locker that they've integrated into the bulkhead, which is a really nice clean look. So down below, you can see just how beautiful the floors are. The woodwork is really in excellent condition, again, for its age. Same with all of the seating, the fabrics. They've just done a nice job. Engine accessibility is right under here. You'll see still photos with the listing, how clean that is. And then we move into our head compartment. So the head compartment has a Japsco toilet that has been replaced. This is underneath this like bench seat, because you can also use this as a shower. There's a shower sump drain right below there. Overhead opening hatch, nice stainless steel sink. And then underneath this opens up, and then you have additional storage there. Same with right behind here in this cabinet. All right, and then to the opposite side, we have our master stateroom. This stateroom right here is quite large. We have this really nice large berth here that kind of goes the whole length of the vessel. So you have lots of, space underneath here. There are two opening hatches, this being one of them into the cockpit. We also have our battery switches here, engine access compartment to get to the back of the engine, hanging locker, and again, really nice LED lighting throughout the boat, and beautifully done.
I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 1991 Beneteau 32S5 that's located here in Mission Bay, California, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully getting you and your family or friends and loved ones out on the water this summer. Thanks again. Bye for now.